Unabashedly, Justin and I are trying to help you see and argue for a proper hermeneutic.
Yep.
And our argument would be that we think Scripture teaches a redemptive historic understanding of Scripture, that all of Scripture is about Christ redeeming for us the kingdom that was lost, right? He created Eden. He created this beautiful relationship between the king and its subjects, and it got destroyed. And so what does Jesus promise? I have come to proclaim the good news of the kingdom, the restoration. What does Paul say? We are ambassadors. Be reconciled to God, right? Mm-hmm. So the whole story is about God reconciling people to himself to restore the kingdom that has been lost. And so this is why our tagline is to clarify the gospel and to reclaim the purpose of the kingdom. And we think the clearest hermeneutic of that is a redemptive historical understanding of Scripture, also known as covenant theology.
Just to put a bow on this conversation, we all want to be people of the Word. Hmm. And we all want to be faithful students of the Word. We want to handle it rightly. We want to interpret it correctly. And we will not do ourselves or anyone that we know a service if we act as though we're the first people to read the Scriptures.
Yeah.
And we ignore creeds and confessions that have been produced through history that have stood the test of time. And so don't wig out. We're not, we are sola scriptura guys. The Scripture, the Scripture alone, you know, is our final and ultimate authority. And there are a number of helpful resources over a couple of thousand years subservient to the Scriptures that help us understand it. Don't That's be right. allergic to the talk of system. Don't be allergic to the talk of frameworks, because the Scripture itself presents these things. So take a breath, study the Scriptures, study church history. All of this will be of great profit to you. Mm. And I agree with you wholeheartedly. If you take away anything from today, the entirety of the Scripture is a testimony about Christ, his person, his work, what he would come to do to reconcile us to God and give us life eternal.
Mm. Amen to that.
Thank you for listening. Today's reminder is from a recent Theocast episode hosted by John Moffitt and Justin Perdue. Everyday Grace is a listener-supported podcast. If you would like to help support our ministry, please visit theocast.org/give.